नमस्ते, आई एम श्रीनिवासन फ्रॉम कृष्णमाचार्य योग मंदिरम चेन्नई। दिस इंस्टीट्यूट स्टार्टेड बाय अवर टीचर श्री टी के वी देसिकाचार, सन ऑफ द लेजेंडरी योगाचार्य श्री कृष्णमाचार्य 40 इयर्स बैक। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू हैव अ प्रैक्टिस ऑफ आसना एंड प्राणायाम। Before starting this practice, there are some points to be noted. We are going to do some asana practices. In this asana practice, I am going to give a instruction. Just to follow the instruction, those who are not able to do the same way, you can modify. We are also going to introduce a modified version of that posture. And importantly, just listen to your body. Don't go beyond your capacity. Wherever you feel little discomfort, stop there. Just listen to your body. That is very, very important. Because by doing the practice, we should not create any discomfort. After the practice, we must feel energetic and very calm and quiet. So, when you are watching and doing the practice, go up to your comfortable level, modify the posture according to your body condition. Now we will start the practice. Now sit in a comfortable position, whether you can sit on the mat. If you can able to sit in a cross leg position, it's okay, or otherwise you can sit on a stool or a chair. Place one palm on the chest, one palm on the abdomen, slightly chin down, eyes close, just to start observing the breath. On inhale, feel the expansion of the chest and slightly protruding the upper abdomen. On exhale, contract the abdomen slowly and relax the chest. When you are inhaling, you have to feel the expansion. Exhaling, you feel the contraction. With closed eyes, just observe the breath. Do it for 6 breaths. Inhale, feel the expansion. Exhale, feel the contraction. Inhale, feel the expansion of the chest and the upper abdomen. Exhale, feel the contraction of the abdomen and relaxing the chest. Inhale, feel the expansion of the chest and the upper abdomen. Exhale, feel the contraction of the abdomen and relaxing the chest. Inhale, exhale. Just observe the breath. Inhale, feel the breath. Exhale, just feel the relaxation. Inhale, expand the chest and the upper abdomen. Exhale, just relax the chest and contract the abdomen. Take few normal breath. Now you can stand up. Stand in a comfortable position. Feet slightly open. That is, feet slightly apart. Stand with back straight. Arms relaxed. Now close the fist. Completely tighten the fist. Inhale, raise the arms from the front, go up, pause there, open the fingers. Now exhale, lower the arms from the front. Now close the fist. Inhale, raise the arms from the front, fully stretched, open the fingers. Now feel the entire stretch of the spine. Exhale, slowly lower the arms from the front. Now close the fist. Inhale, raise the arms from the front completely. Now stretch the spine little more. Feel the extension of the spine. Open the fingers. Exhale, slowly lower the arms from the front. Inhale, raise the arms with the closed fist from the front, stretch fully. Feel the extension of your spine. Open the fist. Exhale, slowly lower the arms from the front. So this is what is called Tadasana, where we are stretching our spine little more and stretching the arms, shoulder blades, so that we can feel the entire area is stretched. Now take few normal breath. Now we are going to do a posture called Virabhadrasana. Set standing posture. Stand straight. Left leg forward. Right foot slightly tanned away. Body tanned to the front. Inhale, bend the front knee and open up the chest. Exhale, lower the arm, straighten the leg. Inhale, bend the front knee, raise the arms up to shoulder level and open up the chest. Exhale, lower the arms. You can bend the knee according to your comfort level, not force. Inhale, bend the front knee and open up the chest. Exhale, lower the arms, straighten the leg. Now the left leg come back, stand straight. Now right foot forward, left foot slightly turned away. Inhale, bend the front knee and open up the chest. Feel the expansion of the chest. Feel the opening up of the chest. Exhale, lower the arms, straighten the leg. Inhale, bend the front knee, raise the arms from the shoulder level and open the chest. Feel the expansion of the chest. Feel the stretch happening in the chest region. Exhale, lower the arms, straighten the leg. Inhale, bend the front knee and open up the chest. Elbows can be bent if you have any issue on your neck. Exhale, lower the arms and straighten the leg. Now the right leg comes back. Stand straight. Take few normal breath. Now we are going to do another posture called Uttanasana. Now inhale, raise the arms from the front. Exhale, bend forward. Place the palms near the feet. Inhale, come up. Arm should lead the movement. Exhale, lower the arms. Those who are not able to do this posture, they can do this in front of a stool or a cart, where you inhale, raise the arms from the front. Exhale, bend forward halfway and place the palms on the stool. then inhale, come up, exhale, lower the arms. This is one of the modification. Other modification, you can very well bend the knee so that you will not have the strain on your back. Those who are prone to back pain or sciatica pain, don't do this posture, or do it very modified way up to your comfort level. Now we'll go to the posture. Stand straight. Inhale, raise the arms from the front. Exhale, bend forward. Go up to comfort level. You can bend the knee or go halfway or place the palms on the floor. Now inhale, slowly come up. Exhale, just lower the arms. One more time, we'll see. Just do. Inhale, raise the arms from the front. Exhale, bend forward. You can bend both the knees and go slowly up to a comfort level where you can go halfway or you can go completely, touch the floor. Inhale, come up, arm should lead the movement. Exhale, lower the arms. So when you are doing this posture, you have to be a little careful about whether you feel any discomfort on the back or your knees. Just observe, modify accordingly. Now we are going to do a kneeling posture called Chakravakasana, where kneel down, bend forward. This is the starting position. Inhale, just move forward, straighten the elbow, look up, arch the back. Exhale, head down, slowly come back with the elbow bent. Elbows are not touching the floor. Your back is not touching the floor. Inhale, just move forward, straighten the elbow, look up, arch the back. Those who have any knee issues, they can place a pillow below the knee for a cushion effect. Exhale, head down, just slide back. Inhale, move forward, straighten the elbow, look up, arch the back. Exhale, head down, just slide back. As I already said, those who have any knee issues, knee pain, they can place the pillow below the knees before starting the practice. Now just lie down, take a minute rest, count 60 to 1 backwards mentally. Relax yourself, complete relaxation. Regain your breath for a minute. Now in a lying position, we are going to do a posture called Dvipadapeetam, where you bend both the knees, place the feet closer to your body, your butt, up to your comfort level. Now on inhale, raise the hip up. Exhale, lower the hip. When you are raising the hip, go up to your comfort level. Those who want to have a small pillow for the head, they can use the pillow for the head. Inhale, raise the hip up. Exhale, slowly lower the hip. Inhale, raise the hip up. Feel the stretch of your back and opening of the chest. Exhale, slowly lower the hip. One last time. Inhale, raise the hip up. Feel the stretch of the spine and opening up of the chest. Exhale, slowly lower the hip. So this helps us extending your spine. It also helps in releasing tension in the shoulders. Open up the chest. Now we'll do another posture as a counter pose and also works on the abdomen called Apanasana. Bend both the knees, hold both the knees with the respective palms. Inhale in this position. On exhale, bring the knee towards the chest. Inhale, move the knees away from the chest. Exhale, bring the knees towards the chest. Inhale, away from the chest. Exhale, bring the knees towards the chest. Inhale, move the knees away from the chest. One last time. Exhale, bring the knees towards. Inhale, move the knees away from the chest. Now place both the feet on the floor. Stretch both the legs. Take few normal breath. This posture ensures the stretching of your spine. Also have some work on your abdomen region. Now bend both the knees. We are going to do another posture called Jatara Parivritti, the twist. Bend both the knees. Place both palms up to your shoulder level. Palms facing the floor. Inhale in this position. Exhale, bring both the knees towards the left side. Just twist towards the left side. Inhale, bring the legs to the center. Exhale, bring both the knees towards the right side. Go up to your comfort level. No need to touch the floor. Inhale, come to the center. Exhale, go to the left side. Slowly go up to your comfort level. Inhale, bring the knees to the center. Exhale, bring both the knees towards the right side. Slowly go up to your comfort level. Inhale, come to the center. Exhale, twist both the legs towards the left side. Slowly go to the left side. Inhale, center. Exhale, bring both the knees towards the right side. Slowly twist. Go up to your comfort level. If possible, go up to the floor. Inhale, bring the knees towards the center. Now lower the arms. Now catch both the knees. We are going to do the Apanasana again as a counter pose for this twist. Hold both the knees. Inhale in this position. Exhale, bring the knees towards the chest. Inhale, away from the chest. Exhale, towards the chest. Inhale, away. Exhale, towards. Inhale, away. One last time. Exhale, towards. Inhale, away. Now place both the feet on the floor. Stretch both the legs. Arms relax. Just take some few normal breath. Relax breathing. Now bend both the knees in the lying position itself. Place one palm on the chest, one on the abdomen. Inhale, feel the expansion of the chest and the expansion of the upper abdomen. Exhale, feel the contraction of the abdomen relaxing the chest. See to it your exhalation is little longer your inhalation. Inhale, feel the expansion of the chest and slightly the upper abdomen comes up. Exhale, feel the contraction of the abdomen slowly relaxing and relax the chest. A longer exhale. Inhale, feel the expansion and slight protrusion of the upper abdomen. Exhale, feel the contraction, relaxing the chest. Inhale, feel the expansion, the chest is completely expanded and you feel slight protrusion of the upper abdomen. On exhale, slowly contract the abdomen and completely relaxing the chest. Inhale, feel the expansion. Exhale, a longer exhale, feel the contraction, slowly exhale. One last time. Inhale, complete inhale, expand the chest and the upper abdomen. Exhale, relaxing the abdomen, contracting the abdomen, relaxing the chest. Now stretch both the legs, take few normal breath, relax to wait. Now tan to one side and sit in a comfortable position. Whether you can able to sit in a cross leg position or you can able to sit on the stool or a chair, wherever possible, sit comfortably but back straight, shoulders relax, arms relax, see to it your back is erect. Up to your comfort level. Now we are going to start a pranayama called Anuloma Ujjayi, where we are going to inhale through both the nostril, exhale through the alternate nostril. For to have a nostril control, we can have a mudra like this, or you can hold your nostril with this mudra. So whatever is possible, you can do. Now place the fingers where the bone and cartilages meets. This way, whenever there is a nostril control. In this pranayama, what we are going to do is, inhale both nostril, exhale left nostril, closing the right, I am exhaling through my left nostril. And lower the arms. Inhale both nostril. Exhale right nostril, closing the left. Inhale both nostril. Exhale left nostril. Inhale both nostril, exhale right nostril. Inhale both nostril, exhale left nostril. Inhale both nostril, exhale right nostril. This pranayama helps to extend my exhalation. Extending exhalation means I am throwing out whatever is not necessary in my body, I am expelling more toxins. So this pranayama helps to eliminate that which is not required in the body. The next pranayama we are going to do, the Nadi Shuddhi or Nadi Shodhana pranayama, where we are going to do alternate nostril breathing. The technique is inhale left nostril, exhale right nostril, inhale right nostril, exhale left nostril. So you can inhale and exhale up to your comfort level. Try to expand your chest and abdomen on inhale. Try to contract your abdomen and relaxing the chest on exhale. So we'll start this Nadi Shodhana Pranayama. Now the Nadi Shodhana Pranayama, have the mudra, place it where the bone meet the cartilage. Inhale, chin slightly down, inhale through the left nostril. Exhale, right nostril. Inhale, right nostril. Exhale, left nostril. See to it your exhalation is little longer than your inhalation. Now, inhale left nostril. Exhale right nostril. Inhale right nostril. Exhale left nostril. Inhale left nostril. Exhale right nostril. Inhale right nostril. Exhale left nostril. Inhale left nostril. Exhale right. Inhale right. Exhale left. So we have done 4 rounds. If you are having more time, you can do 6 cycle or 10 cycles according to your time available. See to it, it should be done within your capacity. Now this Nadi Shodhana Pranayama will balance the energy inside the body. It activates both sides of the brain. It also gives more prana inside the body. That is very, very important for our survival and to have improved immune system. We need more prana. So this pranayamas help in increasing the prana inside our system. Now we'll end up with the practice with the chant of Shantihi. Shanti means peace, calm, quiet, serene. You can use this chant as Om Shantihi, or you can use only Shantihi, just reminding the concept of peace and calm inside us and external also. Place both palm on the chest. Close your eyes. Just chant. Inhale. Shantihi. Inhale. Shanti, shantihi. Shanti, shanti, shantihi. Now the same chant should be done with only lip movement, not making a sound. Inhale. One shanti. Now two. Inhale. Now three. Inhale. Now the same thing to be repeated mentally. One shanti, two shanti, three shanti. Just mentally chant when you are exhaling. After that, slowly lower the arms, take few normal breath, relax breathing, just observe the breath, feel the breath, feel the prana completely going inside your body, feel the circulation of prana. Just connect with your inner core. Just sit silent for 1 minute. After a minute or two, gently open the eyes. So we have done asana, pranayama and a kind of meditative practice at the end of the session. Just practice this within your time available. You can extend instead of 3 times or 4 times, you can do 6 times. Or if you want to shorten, you can do 3 times all the postures. The important aspect is coordination of the breath and the movement. Feel the body when you do the asana practice, feel the breath when you do the pranayama practice, connect with your inner self when you are sitting silence. This capsule of practice helps us to improve our flexibility, strength, energy, more prana inside the body, strengthening our immune system, making the mind calm and quiet. Thank you.